Our top international focus, the counting is underway for 650 seats in the United Kingdom. The latest numbers indicate that Ed Miliband's Labour Party is trailing. David Cameron's Conservative is also close to winning 22 seats at this moment. Now, the Scottish National Party, which is expected to stun this elections, has won close to 16 seats till now. The key fight is seen between Conservative leader David Cameron and Labour Party's Ed Miliband. Now, the votes are being counted in the UK general election. In a few hours from now, poll results will be out as to how many seats each party has won in the House of Commons. While an exit poll predicting Prime Minister David Cameron's Conservatives will be the largest party in the House of Commons, the poll predicts Cameron's party will win 316 seats short of an outright majority, but close to the magic number. The magic number, remember, is 326 in the UK House of Commons. Prime Minister David Cameron's Conservatives and Miliband's opposition Labour are locked in the most closely fought polls that the world's fifth largest democracy has seen recently. If either the Conservatives or Labour have more than half the 650 seats, they can quickly form a government. But that does not seem likely at this moment if the exit poll numbers are to be believed at this moment. Exit poll figures put the Conservatives, the ruling Conservatives, at 316, short by 10 seats of the halfway mark, and also closely followed by the Labour Party, who were the opposition and, according to the exit polls, are likely to remain in the opposition. We have Lavina Tandon joining us from London at this moment. Lavina, this is a closely contested fight, and as you were telling us just a short while ago, it seems that India has moved on to a single party majority rule, whereas the UK, which was always known to throw up a majority government, the second time around could be throwing a minority government. Last time around there was a coalition government at in power. What is likely to happen this time around? Take us through the latest trends and the latest results. All right, we seem to be having some trouble connecting with Lavina. We'll go across to her in just a short moment. But there you can see, while India has moved on to electronic voting machines, these are pictures that are coming in of voting and counting basically taking place in the United Kingdom. It's still being done manually. A lot of countries in the world, despite the fact that they have the best of technology available to them, prefer the ballot, prefer counting manually instead of using the electronic voting machine. And that seems to be the case in the United Kingdom as well. Let's go across to Lavina. She's back with us. Morning, Lavina. It's very, very early morning there in England. Just take us through what really are the early trends, as well as the results that are pouring in at this moment.
Yes, of course. We still see that that Labour is leading with about 38 seats from the last time I saw, and Conservatives with 16, UP with about 5, SNP with 16, and LF by 1. But the exit polls still maintain that Conservatives will ultimately get the highest majority, though not, will turn out to be the largest party, but they will not get any majority as such. That's what we are looking at, and the majority that we're looking at is 326. So yes, in the tally is still meeting, but it is still later in the earlier in the day, really. So yes, I've got the latest now. It's Labour 27, SNP 16. One second, as we speak, I am getting the tally on my. So SNP 16, Conservatives 13, Plaid Cymru 2, Lib Dems 1, and UKIP 0. So Labour leading the polls at this point in time, but it is just 3 o'clock in the morning. In a matter of about 2-3 hours, we're going to get lots of seat declarations. And as you see, there I'm standing behind me. The counting is going on, and one of the two major seats that that affect the migrant vote power, the highest migrant vote power seats, are being counted now, and the counting is not yet finished. Likewise, we will see that lots of seats have not yet been counted into, and therefore they're maintaining the exit polls with Conservatives turning out to be the largest party.
Right, Lavina, do stay on with us. In fact, as UK gets ready for a new government, we get you 10 Downing Streets Indian connection. Take a look at this presentation that we have prepared. Prime Minister Cameron knows how to appease his Indian origin voters, a predominantly Gujarati crowd in the biggest Swaminarayan Mandir of London, during his recent campaign visit. In fact, all the main parties are trying hard to woo the black and Asian ethnic minority votes, and amongst them, Indian origin voters. After all, they form 615,000 votes out of the 4 million first-time voters born outside Britain. Prime Minister Cameron did not leave any stone unturned to say all the right things, from talking about the importance of the Indian diaspora in the UK to pitching for Prime Minister Modi's visit to the UK.
And I want to welcome Prime Minister Modi to Britain at the earliest opportunity.
Though the ethnic diaspora does not vote in bloc, yet Labour has been their traditional favourite, and some say this is changing. The Indian diaspora vote slowly but gradually is moving towards the Tories. Labour is doing their best to retain their loyals by their ethnic diaspora specific manifesto. Leader of opposition Labour Party's Ed Miliband is making huge efforts to seek support from the Indian community. He too visited another Swaminarayan Mandir in London. And a usual quiet and low-key campaigning in the UK turned into a colourful and musical event. While Cameron and Miliband have been visiting temples, Lib Dems' Nick Clegg found the way to votes through their tummies. He went all the way to Cardiff to cook Indian curry in a Bangladeshi restaurant.
I'm going on a sort of culinary tour. And
There seems to be no doubt that this elections, political parties in the United Kingdom are making their best bet to convert the undecided ethnic minority vote to their favour.
From showing faith in the Hindu philosophy of karma to saying that he's looking forward to welcome Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Britain and also personalizing Ab Ki Baar Modi Sarkar to phir ek baar Cameron Sarkar, Prime Minister Cameron hit right notes with the people of Nizam Temple of Indian origin, specifically the Gujarati people. Indian population, the Indian origin diaspora is gaining its influence in the UK and is becoming more and more significant with every passing election.
With Bureau Reports, Headlines Today.